What's up, everybody? This is your music teacher, Mr. C, and welcome back to my channel. Today, we are going to be writing notes. Now, friendly reminder, since I'm using YouTube Live to make these lessons, that means that although you can see and hear me, I cannot see or hear you. So after this lesson's over, if you have questions or want to turn in your work, all you have to do is send me an email or post a message in the Google Classroom. Is everybody ready? Let's begin. Today we're going to be writing down five different kinds of notes. This is going to prepare you for fourth grade, where you're going to be working with the recorder and making a lot more music in music class every single day. So, although we don't write notes all the time, we have gone over these note lengths a bunch. We've done music math, we've done a whole bunch of music math, we've done the jelly bean contest, we've watched videos about this, we've talked about note lengths a whole bunch. So I'm not going to make you watch any videos to refresh your memory, I'm just going to expect that you all remember how much they're worth. I will review those note lengths as we are writing them down, but mostly today, I just want you to focus on actually writing the notes. Now, one slightly annoying thing about this lesson is you can't just type into a Google Doc. You need to actually have a pencil and paper in front of you so you can write these notes down. That's because in order for you to practice writing them, you have to actually do it with your hands. This is not something that you can type into your Chromebook. So find any pen or pencil or crayon or marker, anything you want to write with, and just any sheet of paper. It can be a blank piece of paper, a lined piece of paper. It can be scrap paper. You can write on a napkin. It doesn't really matter. Just some piece of paper that you can write these notes on so that we can practice writing all five down. Also, although you only have to turn one of each note into me, that's what the assignment says, really, you can write down as many of them as you want. If you're finding that it's a little tricky to draw stems or flags, or that you're having more trouble drawing a half note than you are a whole note or something like that, no big deal. You can write down three or four of them for practice, and then I will just grade the best ones. So no stress, write down as many as you need to, and that won't matter. If you're happy with the first one that you write, then you only have to write one, and you can turn that into me as well. All right, let's talk about the notes. The first note that you have to write is a whole note. A whole note, you might remember, is worth 4 beats. It's the largest note that we're going to talk about today. A whole note is round, it is not filled in, and it does not have a stem. Try to draw a whole note now. All right, let's talk about the second kind of note. This is called a half note. A half note, I'm sure you all remember, is worth 2 beats. A half note looks sort of like a whole note because the head is not filled in. However, there is a stem attached to a half note. So try to draw a half note now. All right, good work so far. Let's talk about the third kind of note. This note is called a quarter note. I'm sure I don't have to tell you this. A quarter note is worth 1 beat. A quarter note looks similar in shape to a half note, except that the head is filled in. So remember when you're drawing a quarter note that you have to fill it in. A quarter note also has a stem. Try drawing a quarter note now. All right, let's move on to our fourth kind of note. This is called an eighth note. An eighth note looks pretty similar to a quarter note. The head is filled in, it has a stem, but an eighth note also has a flag. You might notice that curvy part to the right there. An eighth note is a little bit tricky to draw, so this is the one that you might find yourself drawing more than one version of. Of course, if you just draw it once and you're happy with the result, you can send that eighth note in to me and it's totally fine. Try to draw an eighth note now. An eighth note, by the way, is worth 1/2 beat. It is the shortest note that we are learning about today. All right, let's look at the fifth note type. This is a dotted half note. It looks pretty much the same as the regular half note that you drew before. The head is not filled in, it has a stem, but a dotted half note, like the name suggests, has a dot to the right of it. Now, a dotted half note is worth 3 beats. That's because the dot adds 1 beat, and the half note was already worth 2. Simple math tells us that 2 + 1 = 3, so a dotted half note is worth 3 beats. Try drawing a dotted half note now. Well, guess what, everybody? You just completed the entire assignment. That was it. If you were drawing while this lesson was going on, then you're already done. Now all you have to do is go and hit the turn in button and I will know that you did this assignment. Of course, if you would like to send it to me, you can take a picture with a phone or a tablet and then send it to my email address or post it in this Google Classroom. Just don't forget to hit turn in. Again, you don't have to send me the pictures. If you stayed for this entire lesson, I will know that you did it. But of course, if you want to send me the pictures, you can do that too. Thank you so much for coming by to watch this lesson. I'm excited to see everybody next week in my virtual music classroom. Keep living the dream. Don't stop believing.